Hi, welcome. So we will continue our series in C programming, and so far we have already talked about how to write a simple hello world program. We will build upon that and we will write another simple program, but it will help us teach a lot of new simple concepts that we will visit again later into the course, but we will write a simple program. So the program today that we will write is simply to convert temperature from Fahrenheit into Celsius. So we will essentially take temperatures from 0 to 300 degree Fahrenheit at the steps of 20. So 0 degree Fahrenheit, 20 degree Fahrenheit, 40 degree Fahrenheit, and convert them into Celsius. So the 0 degree Fahrenheit corresponds to minus 17, 80 degree Fahrenheit corresponds to 26 degree Fahrenheit, 26 degree Celsius, and so on and so forth. 300 Fahrenheit converts to 148 Fahrenheit. So let's directly jump into the program, and as we encounter new concepts, we can talk about them. So the first thing to do is to first include the standard library and then write the main function. So we will just write everything in the main function. As we talked about last time, main is a special function, and the execution of C programs begin with the main function. So one thing to note is that we need some placeholders for these things. We need some way to store 0, some way to store 300, as well as some way to store that the data step is going to be 20. So I will define variables for that, int lower, upper, and step. Also, I need to be able to store Fahrenheit, which will vary between 0 to 300, 0, 20, 40, etc. As well as I need something to store the corresponding Celsius value. Notice here that I have used something called int. What is int? So let's talk about it quickly. In C, in some programming language, this int is a data type. There are many data types in C. There are integers, there are floating points, floats, doubles, there are characters, there are short, long, etc. What is an integer? Integer essentially, depending on your machine, sometimes can be 4-bit or 8-bit. It is a value from it is just like the mathematical integers go from some negative value to some positive value. For a 4-byte integer, it goes from minus 2147483648 to 2147483647. Floats are used when you have to use decimal places like fractions, then you use floats, and they are with 4 bytes. They have 6 significant digits and vary between 10 to minus 38 to 10 to 38. Doubles are more precise floats. So if you have to do really precise math, you have to do it for scientific purpose or something, then you should use double. But be careful, double use more space than float. So if your use case is that you don't need so precise math, then you are probably fine with using double. A char is a character. It acquires only 1 byte. A character is like A, B, C, D, exclamation mark, comma, star, parenthesis, close, things like that. Short stands for short integer, maybe 2 byte or 4 byte depending on the machine, and long stands for long integer, etc. So that's what integer stands for. Next, now continuing, I want to declare that lower should be 0, upper should be 300, which is my upper boundary, and step should be 20. So I will start from Fahrenheit, which will start at lower, and it should go from lower, which is 0, to and should end in 300 in steps of 20. Now I will write my program such that it will have this loop, the while loop, which, and we'll talk about this loop, it will continue until Fahrenheit is less than equal to upper, so basically the program will run until Fahrenheit is less than equal to 300. So essentially what I will do, let's write some comments, is that the way it will work is that I will first convert Fahrenheit to Celsius, then I will print the result and then I will increase Fahrenheit by step. So basically Fahrenheit will become Fahrenheit plus step. Fahrenheit plus step. That's all that is happening, right? So to convert Fahrenheit to Celsius is easy. I can just say Celsius equals 5 into Fahrenheit minus 32 divided by 9, and that will convert, that will basically do this computation and store it inside Celsius. A thing to notice in C is that before you use any variable, you have to declare it. So I cannot say lower equals 0 until I have declared int lower. The compiler doesn't know. If I did this and I try to compile the program, it will fail. You can see gcc temperature.c in function main error lower undeclared. You need to declare it. So int lower, you need to declare it. Otherwise the compiler complains, it doesn't know what data type lower is. It needs to store some memory for that. Anyways, and then you initialize the variables. You initialize some initial values to them, and then you need to print the results. So let's see. So print f percent, and we'll talk about how this works. Percent d Fahrenheit in Celsius. So now it should become clear to you what the code is doing. We run the while loop while this condition is true. While Fahrenheit is less than equal to upper, do the following: convert Fahrenheit to Celsius, print the result, and increase Fahrenheit by a step of 20. So it will start, Fahrenheit will be 0, it will be converted into Celsius, the result will be printed, Fahrenheit will become 20. Repeat. Is 20 less than equal to 300? Yes. Convert to Celsius, print the result, Fahrenheit becomes 40. Repeat. And this will go on and on until Fahrenheit will become 300. It will come inside one last time, will become 320, go back up. Is 320 less than equal to 300? No. So it will exit out of the loop. And by the way, these parentheses, they represent the body of the while. So any statement that is outside these parentheses is outside the scope of the while loop. So only these three lines and the comments are inside the while loop. That's what these parentheses signify. Similarly, these parentheses signify the scope of the main function. Any line outside is outside the main function. So I can now compile this and I can run this and it will run just fine. Oh, one thing that we forgot is that there has to be a new line character. So there's a new line character, and I compile it and I run it, and the code looks so nice. There is 0 followed by a tab, and then the corresponding Celsius value. 0 corresponds to minus 17, 20 degree Fahrenheit corresponds to minus 6 degree Celsius. How does this function work? So let's talk about it. Printf is not just there to print strings. It is a more general utility function defined in the standard input-output library. So the way it works is that it is a formatting function. The F stands for format, and this is defining the format. What it is saying is that %d means integer. So I'm going to print an integer followed by a tab. So you must have seen the tab key. When I type something and I hit tab, it leaves some space, and I type something and I hit some tab and it leaves something else. So tab is just like white space. So then the tab and then another integer. And what it is saying is that however many percent %d's do you have here is how many arguments you will have to provide. So when it is running, it will replace this first percent %d with the actual Fahrenheit value and replace the second percent %d with the next Celsius actual Celsius value. So if Fahrenheit is 0, Celsius is 3, it will print 0, tab, 3, and then the new line character. So that's how it works. So I hope now this code makes sense to you. Now, there are some issues with this code. And one of the issues with this code is the following. It is saying that 40 degrees Celsius is equal to 4 degrees Fahrenheit. Is that really true? Let's go to Google and ask Google, 40 is 40 Fahrenheit to Celsius? And 40, well, and Google tells me that 40 Fahrenheit is equal to 4.444 Celsius. And I am saying, my program is saying that 40 Fahrenheit is equal to 4 Celsius. That is wrong. I mean, it's not wrong, but it is It is roughly incorrect. It is half result. There is a second problem. What do you think? It's not a problem, but someone can do a mistake. What do you think will happen if I had done this? If I had done this, what will happen is that it will first divide 5 by 9. And because 5 and 9 are literal integers, integer divided by integer, it will return an integer. 5 by 9 will result in 0.44. It will try to convert it into an integer, which will be 0. And so the result, 0 times anything will be 0. And it will always print, if I compile and I run, it will always print Celsius as 0. That's wrong. That's plain wrong. So how do we fix that? The way we fix it is, rather than using integers, it is a much better choice to use float here. Then automatically it becomes, Fahrenheit becomes a float. Fahrenheit is a float. You still need to fix this to 5.0 and 9.0 so that the result is not 5 by 9, otherwise will still become 0. Now it will divide. It will say, oh, 5 is a float and 9 is a float. When I divide it, do not downgrade it to 0 integer. It will become 0.444 and then multiply it with far minus 32. Rather than printing integers, you have to print floats here, so you just replace it with %f. So remember, we'll talk about this in detail. %d is for integer, for printing integer. %f is for printing floats. So remember that. Anyways, so now if I run this program, it will work much more nicely. 40.0 Fahrenheit is equal to 4.444 Celsius, which is more equal, which is more right, which is more correct. It is more accurate. There is still few things that are annoying me. One of them is that, why is it printing so many zeros? 40.00. Do I really want that? No, I don't want it. All I want it to print is 40 or 60 or 120. I don't want all these zeros. So because the maximum I want is 3 decimal places, here I can say I want 3 decimal places and 0 decimal places after dot. So then it will print a 3 wide number and then 0 results after the decimal place. And similarly here I can say, okay, I want 6 long number with 6 digits, not a whole many, and after decimal place maybe 1. So when I do that and I compile the program and I run it, see how nice the result look. It says 0 and there is no decimal place after it. All the dot zeros have disappeared, and in the result it says minus 17.8. after decimal place there is only one result. If I had changed it to %6.2, it will then become more accurate, and then it will basically put 2 decimal place after decimal. So I hope that makes sense. So that I think will conclude today's lecture. We essentially talked about a lot of things. It should take you a little further in understanding of C. We talked about how to declare variables, how to assign values to them. We also talked about various data types. We talked about while loop, and we also took a closer look at how printf works as a formatting. You can pass formats to it. We wrote a simple program to convert Fahrenheit to Celsius. So homework problems for you is that definitely write the program that I wrote and try to run it. The people who are using Windows should consider putting getchar at the end so that the program will wait for them. Otherwise, it will just exit. So definitely put a getchar in the end. And then the homework problems are that you should modify this program so that in the beginning it should print out a heading. It should say Fahrenheit here and Celsius here. So the first row should have a heading and then the result. Second problem is to write a program so that converts Celsius to Fahrenheit. So on the first column you should have 0 to 300 Celsius, and the right column you should have the corresponding Fahrenheit value. So convert Celsius to Fahrenheit. And the third is to, from the Cunningham and Ritchie book, which you should have already downloaded, read the section 1.2, because this lecture closely follows that. Thank you for following. Bye.